this is thank you. should introduce myself.
Well, I introduce you.
My name is Yoshi Nagai. I'm a professor at San Francisco Conservatory of Music, the chair of the piano department.
这位老师是永井满华老师，来自旧金山音乐学院的钢琴系主任。
This is Alex. He's 14 from Wuhan.
然后这位给我们演出的是陈以航同学，他的英文名叫 Alex， 他今年十四岁。
Because we don't have programs, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So the things I liked about your playing is you have a very strong mind, I think. You bring out the dramatic elements of the piece.
老师说他有一个非常强大的这个心灵的把这个曲子里面的戏剧性的这个元素都展现出来。
And I think you are very confident with your performance and with your ideas.
我觉得这个孩子他非常自信，对于自己的这种意识的把握很到位。
Okay. The problem is, I think some of those ideas stop the natural flow of the music.
但老师认为他这个音乐意识中的一些部分把这个音乐很自然的流动性给打断了。
So on the one hand, I like your personal interpretation, that you have an interpretation that is different. On the other hand, maybe it's too complicated. It's unnecessary to have so many ideas.
老师认为自己对于音乐的理解是必要的，但是有的时候这样的理解可能会过于复杂，而且变得不必要。
Yeah. So, this ballad.We all know this ballad, and we all know that Schumann, when he saw the ballad for the first time, when Chopin showed him, Schumann was very pleased by the ballad. He thought it was one of his greatest pieces.
对，当舒曼看到这首曲子，他认为这是肖邦就是最杰出的一首曲子。
And Chopin himself loved this piece. And this is an early piece.You know, up until this time, there weren't a lot of big pieces by Chopin. So there were the waltzes and the scherzo, but this was a very successful piece in Schumann's eyes and Chopin's, first of all, feeling.
就是肖邦的这曲子呢，就是他为数不多的会主唱的这个，而且也是他做的非常杰出的作品。
And I think one of the reasons that we all love this a lot so much is because it has.A great flow, a natural build-up. You know, if you just play the music, it tells the story very clearly. There's a beautiful melodies, it has drama, it has, you know, piano virtuosity. So I feel like the important thing is to hold the structure together.By keeping the rhythm steady, more steady than you are.
这老师说这个曲子呢，它那个戏剧性和旋律都结合得非常好。我认为这个，你需要注意的是把自己的节奏要稳定，要稳定性要稳定。
Okay. What is the meter of the piece? What is the time signature?
它不像一个waltz，但是它不是一个waltz。
The melodies are very waltz-like, but what is the meter? How many beats for every measure?
6.
That is correct. How about the opening?
4.
Okay. Now, I don't feel like you counted one measure in your performance. It's 6.I feel like you just play the way you feel. Is it true? Or are you counting? The key is you should not play like you're counting, but you should feel free like you do. But we should understand the phrases because of the meter. You know, we should understand each phrase and each.Phrase together and each section together. start. What is unusual about the opening?
完全听不到，嗯。
Yes, I think about this opening like the opening of a drama, the curtain. You know, the curtain is opening like that. A big stage, but the curtain opens, but very steady. And it's a very mysterious kind of idea to start in A flat, right? The Neapolitan.
我是说这个乐曲的开篇就像一个很大的这种窗帘，非常稳定的慢慢的打开。
So try to make it very smooth, okay? Very legato. Try again. Is there something that strikes you besides? Are you going for this note or this note or both? How about the voices? You know, Chopin's writing a melody in two hands in this unison. So you have to decide, do you want the upper voice, lower voice, or both voice?
我说这肖邦他写这个曲子的那个左右两手都清楚，所以说你应该决定你要强调的是上下面那个音位。
What's your idea?
Right.
So that's the first thing you have to do better. But now, I think the pedal possibility, it could be more interesting if you... We have B flat, right? And then we have... If he would have written...Practice the notes so much, but actually most of the magic and most of what makes every pianist different is not just the note, but between the note.
我说的是那个，就是我们练琴的时候总是只练的是音符，但其实让每一位钢琴家的风格独特的这个很重要的要素是音符之间的这种运动，这种感觉。
Play the rest of that one more time.No, no, no. two triplets, right? Maybe this piano is a reaction to the forte. Right? So it's a different voice. Start here. So when the dynamic changes, can you change the emotion? Interesting about this chord is this chord has two keys. It has the G minor, right? Which is the key of the piece, and also has E flat. So it has this, the E flat major, which is the very heroic side of the ballade, right? And it has the G minor, which is the very poetic, sad side. So I think this one chord suggests what's going to happen later. It's like, you know the word foreshadow? Foreshadow. Who knows foreshadow? You know this word? Foreshadow, it will, it's a clue, it's a, it shows what will happen later. So when you play that, you should try to hear both minor and major. Crescendo here, and I think that's because he wants you to keep the tension, because it's not a resolution. Can you try? it's the harmony that really makes the melody, give the melody meaning. So all of this is to say, don't miss notes in the harmony. Right? Because you miss notes in the harmony, you miss the meaning. Does that make sense? moment. This beat, not the high point, but the low point. So that you can build.
Thank you.
asking him. I know you know. What does it mean, Sokpa Bodhi?
It's like a long time.
Just play what he wrote. Okay.
把你的节奏。